One of the things that I'm seeing the last several years is the Memorial Day weekend. I'd say busiest and kind of most dangerous times, the calls and the types of calls and the people we're dealing with, you know, over that weekend, you know, a different type of crowd. And so, for example, our Memorial Day weekend last several years, we did the Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, over 90 calls a day in the last 2 years. 90 calls a day.
90 calls a day.
Yeah, there was about 370 calls for service over that Memorial Day weekend. About 365 was in 2022. And there was 12 arrests, DWIs, alcohol-related disturbances, fights, noise complaints. But the last 2 years, that Memorial Day...
So what do you attribute that to?
I can tell you, I think, be honest with you, I think it's the short-term rentals. I think the college crowd is over that Memorial Day weekend. We had 18 motor vehicle crashes. Three resulted in DWI arrests of persons that were under the age of 25.
Okay.
So it's that type of crowd that's coming.
A younger crowd on Memorial
Day. Yeah, I think college kind of, you know, is just getting out. And
yeah.
And look, Brigantine is really having a problem with it. They've got a whole core of their community that homes were built for short-term rentals where they have 8 bedrooms in them. It's problematic. They just introduced, I think they just adopted an ordinance that will significantly pull that back. They're going to do a cost per, I forget, I think $25 per bedroom fee, because they're going to have to hire people to get in there and do that. They estimated their costs in the $500,000 range to manage the short-term rentals over there. They're leaning towards an ordinance that would designate them as commercial uses,
right,
and then create the locations in the city that they would be conditionally approved
to operate under, correct. Yeah.
And then that way you can change the parking demand. Two of the biggest issues is noise and overcrowding. And then the third one is parking. Right. So the problem, if the home is designated as residential, you're under the residential site improvement standards that the state passed. The maximum number of parking spaces you require for a house is 3, no matter how many bedrooms. That's now not a residential property. That's a short-term rental commercial use. You can set your own parking standards. It's not a residence. So if we get to that point, because I'm going to be working with Vince Serra and their team over there to write that ordinance for the planning board. They used a lot of our stuff in their ordinance. And then we're going to probably use some of their stuff if we need to. It's open communication. So that information is helpful.
And I think you did a good job with kind of creatively. So what you did, and correct me if I'm wrong, is to train our officers to say, kind of speak to the owner. If you're not the owner, you kind of find in that interview that they're a short-term rental.
And or just ask the question, you know, are you renting this place for the weekend or the week or for the night?
Right.
And then we tag that as short-term rental in that we had the one problem early in the season on Memorial Day weekend with a property in the Heights that we worked closely with code enforcement. They issued several violations, which was more in their purview than mine. Yeah. So
that's how to manage it.
I mean, and you can't manage it unless you can measure it. So we have this kind of data.
Correct.
It kind of puts us in a point where is it a problem? It feels like a problem because some people have the quality of life in their block might be impacted, but it's in perspective. It's not as huge a problem as we might think. But